Hello everyone, welcome to fourth part of the chapter Control and Coordination. In previous part, we studied about the structure of the brain, which is an important organ of central nervous system. Today, in this video lecture, we will study about a spinal cord, peripheral nervous system, and autonomous nervous system. Student, first of all, we will study about the spinal cord. Spinal cord, it is the elongation or it is the extension of medulla of longata. Student, we have studied medulla of longata. It is the last part of hindbrain or it is the last part of the brain which further continue as a spinal cord. The spinal cord, it is running through vertebral column. It is a long, thin and tubular structure. Vertebral column, it provides the protection to spinal cord. Not only vertebral column, but the meninx, they are also form the covering around the spinal cord like the brain. These meninx, they also provide the protection to spinal cord. We know there are the three meninx present. The outer meninx, it is a dura mater. The middle one, it is the arachnoid, and the innermost meninx, it is a pia mater. Spinal cord, it is a long, it is about 40 to 45 centimeter in length, and its width is about 2 to 2.5 centimeter. Look at the figure. The spinal cord, everywhere it is a knot similar in width. At the two region, that is the cervical region and the lumbar region. You know the cervical region, it is the region present in the neck. And the lumbar region indicates the back region. In this region, spinal cord, it is a little swelled or expanded. This expanded structure present in the cervical region, it is called cervical swelling, and the expanded structure of the spinal cord in the lumbar region, it is called lumbar swelling. The hind part of this spinal cord, it gradually becomes a tapering and it forms the conus medullaris. Conus medullaris, it is present in the region L1 to L2. From conus medullaris onwards, the spinal cord, it becomes the thin filamentous structure called filum terminale. Conus medullaris, it is found between L1 to L2. Here L indicates the lumbar region. The lumbar vertebra 1 to lumbar vertebra 2, the conus medullaris, it is seen. Filum terminal, it is covered by just a single meninx called pia mater. This region, we can find a bunch of the nerves. So, this structure, it appears like horse tail. And it is termed as cauda equina. For the better understanding, student, please look at the figure. The spinal cord, it gives 31 pairs of the nerves. These nerves, they are coming from the region, cervical region, lumbar region, as well as the conus medullaris region. Now, we will study the cross section of spinal cord or the transverse section of the spinal cord. With the help of the transverse section, we will study the internal structure of the spinal cord. For better understanding, student, look at the figure. The dark colored structure present around the figure, it is the border region, which is formed by the meninx, where the three meninx are present, dura mater, arachnoid and the pia mater, which are the protective coverings. Just inner to these coverings, the actual spinal tissue, it is present. Spinal cord, it is made up of nervous tissue. It is divided into two half, right and the left, because of the presence of fissure. The fissure, it is a narrow slit which is present in the front as well as it is present at the back side. The front side fissure, it is called as the anterior median fissure, and the back side posterior median fissure is present. Because of this fissure, their spinal tissue, it is divided into two half. Spinal cord at its center has a narrow cavity. This narrow cavity, it is called as a central canal, which is lined by ependymal cells. It is present in the single layer, and these cells, they are the secretory in nature. They secrete the secretion called CSF, that is the cerebrospinal fluid, which provide the nutrition and the protection to spinal cord. Around the spinal cord, around the central canal, the gray color tissue, it is present called gray matter. Student, do you know why this tissue it is called as a gray matter? Because the color of the tissue, it is a gray in color. You know, the nervous tissue, it is a made up of nerve cells. Nerve cell, which is a structural and functional unit of the nervous tissue. Nerve cell has the cell body and the axon structure. The cell body has cytoplasm called neuroplasm, in which Nissl's granules are present. And the presence of these Nissl's granules, it gives the appearance gray color to the cell body. The axon, which is the long axis which is arising from the nerve cell, which also encloses the cytoplasm called exoplasm. But in the exoplasm, Nissl's granules are absent. And that's why axon part, it is the white. Around the central canal, the part it is a gray, that indicates only the cell body structure, it is a concentrated around the central canal. So the gray color structure, it appears like a butterfly shaped, or it appears like a letter H structure. The next part is the white matter, which is the white in color, and where only the axon fibers are present. It is divided into three columns, or the funiculi, which is present at dorsal, ventral, and the lateral side. Student, now we will see what is the commissure and where it is present. Commissure, it is the horizontal line, or it is a horizontal region which join the two part of the gray matter. As you know, the gray matter, it is H-shaped, and in the letter H, the horizontal portion is indicates the commissure, and this horizontal portion of the gray matter, it connect the two half of the gray matter. So this horizontal portion, it is called as a commissure. In gray matter, there are three horns are present. Dorsal horn on the dorsal side, ventral horn on the ventral side, and on the lateral side, the lateral horn is present. These horns is nothing but these are the dorsal column, lateral column, and the ventral column. Dorsal horn, it gives the extension, or it extend further as a dorsal root. Ventral horn, it extend further as a ventral root. But the lateral horn does not get extended. It does not have the lateral root. But here, the nerve cell which is present, their fibers, it comes out through the ventral root. The lateral horn region, the nerves are present. They are for the autonomous nervous system. Now we'll see about the white matter. The white matter in which the two types of the tracts are present. So what is the tract? Tract is the bundle of nerve fiber. So in the dorsal region of the white matter, the myelinating nerve fibers are present. These myelinating nerve fibers, they are of two types, ascending and the descending. It forms the ascending tract and the descending tract. The ascending tract, it conducts the sensory impulse from spinal cord and it carries further towards the brain. In descending tract, this nerve fiber, it conducts the impulse from brain to spinal cord. So it is a motor in nature. Let us see how the spinal nerves are formed. Dorsal root receives the sensory nerve from the dorsal ganglion. Ventral root, it gives out motor nerve. Both dorsal sensory and ventral motor nerve together form the mixed spinal nerve. It is sensory as well as a motor in type. Spinal nerves, it comes out through opening called intervertebral foramen. This is the opening. It is present between the vertebrae. Immediately, it divides into three branches. These are ramus dorsalis, ramus ventralis, and ramus communicans. Ramus dorsalis, it innervates to dorsal side of skin and the muscles. Ramus ventralis, it is a long branch. It get innervated to the organ and the muscles of the lateral and the ventral side. And the last, ramus communicans, it is the smallest branch. It starts from the first thoracic vertebra to the third lumbar vertebra. So in this region, only this ramus communicans it is present. It joins two sympathetic ganglion. Let us see what are the functions of the spinal cord. Spinal cord, it provides the nerve connection to many parts of the body. It acts as a center for the reflex action. Reflex action, it is a sudden, spontaneous, automatic, involuntary response given to the stimulus. For example, if unknowingly your hand, it is touched to the hot surface. So what is your reaction? Suddenly, you take out your hand from the hot surface. That is the reflex action. And this is completed because of the spinal nerves. Spinal nerves, as you know, they are the mixed type, sensory as well as motor type. So spinal nerves, they are connected to the spinal cord and spinal cord is controlling all these reflex actions. Let us move on second part of nervous system, that is the peripheral nervous system, which include cranial nerves, spinal nerves, and the ganglions, which are present outside the brain and the spinal cord. It is a communication line between the central nervous system and the rest of the body. It has two main parts, that is sensory division and the motor division. Sensory division has sensory nerve. Their nerve fibers conducts impulse from receptor to central nervous system. Motor division has motor nerves. They conduct the impulse from central nervous system to effector organs, that is muscles and the glands. Motor division further classified into two types?
There are two types of peripheral nervous system, somatic nervous system and autonomic nervous system. Somatic nervous system, it is connect the voluntary muscles with the central nervous system by cranial nerves and the spinal nerves. The autonomic nervous system, it connect the involuntary organs or the smooth muscles with the central nervous system.
The spinal cord, it gives the nerves. Those nerves are called as the spinal nerves. They are 31 pairs. They are arising from the spinal cord and they are connecting to the voluntary organs or the skeletal muscles. In cervical region of the spinal cord, 8 pairs of the spinal nerves, they are coming out. In the thoracic region of the spinal cord, 12 pairs of the spinal nerves are present. In lumbar region, 5 pairs are present. In sacral region, 5 pairs are present. And in the coccygeal region, a pair of a nerve is present. So the total is 31. Cranial nerves, it is also a part of peripheral nervous system. This nerve, it is arise from the various regions of the brain. It connect the central nervous system with the voluntary organs or the skeletal muscles. Cranial nerves, there are 12 pairs. They are always denoted with the Roman numbering. On the basis of its function, they are classified into 3 types of the nerves: sensory nerve, motor nerve, and the mixed nerve. Student, look at the chart. With help of the chart, we will study cranial nerves, its nature and the function. The cranial nerves, as you know, they are 12 in pairs. The first pair of the cranial nerve, it is named as olfactory nerve. It is sensory type and it controls the sense of smell. The second pair of cranial nerve, it is the optic nerve. It is also sensory and it controls the vision function. Third cranial nerve, it is the oculomotor. It is a motor in nature and it controls the movement of eyeball. Fourth one, it is a pathetic. It is a motor in nature and it helps in the rotation and the movement of the eyeball. The fifth one, trigeminal. It is a mixed type of the nerve that is both sensory as well as the motor in nature. Okay, it functions for the sensation of the skin, particularly touch. It also controls the taste and the movement of the jaw. The sixth one, it is the abducens. It is also the motor in nature and it controls the movement of the eye. Seventh one, it is the facial. This nerve, it is a mixed type. It controls all facial expression. It controls the movement of the neck, secretion of tears. It controls the taste function and the salivary secretion. The eighth cranial nerve, its name is auditory. It is a sensory in nature and it functions for the hearing. It controls the functions of the hearing and the equilibrium. The ninth one, it is a glossopharyngeal. It is a mixed type and it controls the function taste, salivation as well as swallowing. Tenth one, it is a vagus. It is a mixed type of the nerve. It controls the visceral movements, which include breathing, cardiac movement, gastric movement, pancreatic secretion, and the gastrointestinal movements. All it is under the control of vagus nerve. The 11th cranial nerve, it is a spinal accessory. Its nature is motor. It controls the movement of larynx, that is the sound box, pharynx, that is the throat region, neck, and the shoulder. It is under the control of spinal accessory. And the last one, that is the 12th cranial nerve, it is a hypoglossal, it is a motor in nature and it controls the movement of a tongue. So this is what about the cranial nerves and its nature and the function. Let us move on the next part of the peripheral nervous system, that is autonomic nervous system. It transmits the impulse from central nervous system to involuntary organs and the smooth muscles of the body. It consists of peripheral nerves that regulate the activity of involuntary organs like cardiac muscle, smooth muscles, and the glands. Autonomic nervous system consists of two systems, sympathetic nervous system and the second one, parasympathetic nervous system. Let us understand about the functioning of autonomous nervous system with the help of this simple figure. Autonomous nervous system include ganglion and the nerves. Look at the figure. The pink color body indicates the ganglion and green color lines indicate the nerve fibers. In ganglion, neuron cells are present. These neuron cells connect the central nervous system with involuntary organ by preganglionic nerve fiber and postganglionic nerve fiber respectively. Preganglionic nerve fibers, they are present between central nervous system and the ganglion, while postganglionic nerve fiber, it is present between ganglion and involuntary organ or the smooth muscles. In case of sympathetic nervous system, the ganglions are close to spinal cord. So the length of preganglionic fiber, it is short, and postganglionic nerve fiber, it is long. As involuntary organs, they are away from ganglion. In parasympathetic nervous system, the position and the length of the nerve fiber, it is just opposite to sympathetic nervous system. In parasympathetic nervous system, ganglions, they are very close to involuntary organs, or we say they are away from central nervous system. Hence, in this case, preganglionic nerve fibers are long and the postganglionic nerve fibers are short. Hope you understood the position of ganglion and the length of nerve fiber of preganglionic nerve fiber and the postganglionic nerve fiber in case of the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system. The sympathetic nervous system, it consists of 22 pairs of sympathetic ganglion. They are present on lateral side of spinal cord. They are 3 in cervical region, 11 pairs in thoracic region, 4 pairs in lumbar region, 5 pairs it is in sacral region, sum is 22 pairs. This ganglion, it controls the activity during the emergency, that is during the fear, fight and the flight, or we say 3F condition. During this emergency condition, postganglionic fibers release hormone called adrenaline and the non-adrenaline. This hormone, it gives the excitation and the stimulatory effect to involuntary organs and the smooth muscles. Except the digestion and the excretion organs, where this excitation and the stimulation effect, it is not seen, but these organs, they get inhibited during the fear, flight and the fight condition. So their activity, it is a slew. During emergency condition, sympathetic nervous system, it gives a response. During that time, parasympathetic nervous system, it is a slow down. It gives the response only during the resting condition and the digestion by secretion of acetylcholine. In resting condition, respiration rate, heart rate, it is decreased. But digestion rate, it is increased. So it is a stimulatory to digestion, but it is inhibitory to respiration and the cardiac functioning. Let us study about how the sympathetic and the parasympathetic nervous system function antagonistically to maintain the homeostasis of the body. You know that the sympathetic nervous system is active during the fight and the flight condition, that is during the emergency conditions. During that time, the pupil, it get dilated, heartbeat increases, airways get dilated, liver stimulate the conversion of glycogen, sweat gland stimulate the secretion of the sweat, digestive system get retarded, its peristalsis, adrenal secretion, it is increases, tear gland gets stimulate for the secretion of the tears, salivary gland inhibit the flow of saliva, urinary system, it get relaxed, the bladder, blood vessels constrict and blood pressure increases. This is all during the sympathetic nervous system. During the parasympathetic nervous system activation, it is seen during the resting time or during the pleasure time. During this phase of parasympathetic nervous system, pupil, it get constricted, heartbeat decreases, airways, it get constricted, liver stimulate the release of bile, sweat gland inhibit the secretion of sweat, digestive system accelerate its peristalsic activity, adrenal gland decreases the adrenaline, tear gland inhibit the secretion of the tears, salivary gland stimulate the flow of saliva, urinary system get contracted, and the bladder size it is decreased, blood vessel dilate and the blood pressure decreases. Like this way, both the system, they maintain the homeostasis. It helps to maintain the homeostasis in the body.
Let us summarize the human nervous system with the help of this chart. Human nervous system, broadly, it is classified into central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system, it includes brain and the spinal cord. While peripheral nervous system, it includes two divisions, motor neuron division and sensory neuron division. Student, up till now we have studied about the human nervous system. Now let us start, what are the disorders which is related with this, the human nervous system? The disorders like mental disability, mental retardation, bipolar disorder, depression, anxiety, stress, all these affect the mood, thinking and the behavior of the human being, as well as it also affect on interaction and the communication. Let us study about Parkinson's disease. It is a one of the disorder which is related with the nervous system, in which dopamine producing nerve cells, they get degenerated, and because of that dopamine formation, it is get affected or it get reduces. Dopamine, it is a neurotransmitter which help to transmit the message between the nerve cells, which control muscles and its movement. Generally, people of age over 65 may get affected by Parkinson's disease. It shows the symptoms in which the stoop posture is one of the symptoms is there. Stoop posture, or it is also called round shoulder. Shoulder is not straight, it becomes curved, and because of that, neck pain or the back pain may be observed. Round shoulder, it is because of disalignment of spine curve. As the voluntary muscles are affected because of less secretion of dopamine, the hand shaking or the hand tremors is seen in one arm or the hand. The muscles rigidity, freezing of muscle, difficulty in walking, shuffling of the steps, reduced arm swing, slow down movement, These symptoms also seen in Parkinson's disease. Depression, problem with the memory, and sleep problems, they are also seen in Parkinson's disease. Next nervous system disorder is Alzheimer's disease. It is a brain disorder. Look at the figure. Here we can see the healthy brain and the severe affected Alzheimer's brain, which is a shrink brain. This is caused because of accumulation of amyloid protein and the loss of acetylcholine producing nerve cells. It affects on brain functions, memory, and your behavior. It is a form of dementia in which the loss of memory, confusion, and the dysfunctioning of the brain it is seen. It is increases with the age. About 7 in 10 people with the dementia have Alzheimer's disease. There is no cure for the Alzheimer's disease. The treatment can slow down progression of disease or the development of the disease towards more advanced stage. Hope you understood today's topic. Thank you for watching this video. Do like, share, and subscribe this channel.